Sustainability. Do you know the meaning of sustainability? My definition is meeting our own needs without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs without exploiting the earth.
I'm Sarah Rodenburg and I'm here to talk about sustainability. It's a topic that's already been talked about a lot. It's trending on social media and a lot of people are using the hashtag sustainability or sustainable. But do they know what it means? Do you know what it means? Do you know how to explain it?
There are already a lot of sustainable things happening in the world, but also a lot of pollution. Why does the world still look like this while we know things need to change?
Gave you an explanation about the word sustainability. I found this definition by doing my research during my expedition. Another thing I found doing during my research is the three-pillar model. That's a model that I would like to use to explain the word sustainability a little bit more.
The first pillar is environmental. It has to do with the environment. An example for that is climate protection or protection of resources. The second pillar is economical. It has to do with money. An example for that is in-season foods. The third pillar is social. It has to do with people. An example for that is poverty. All pillars are connected. You can see it also with the roof. If we look at the example, for example, more in-season foods, that is connected to more jobs closer by, which helps improve poverty. And if people have more money, they can make more sustainable options. And because of that, there will be less pollution, and that helps climate change. If we look again at the example, more in-season foods. It helps with less transportation because it's closer by, which means less pollution, which means help in the climate change. It all comes together, even when you don't see the results yourself.
If it influences so much, why are people not doing more? I had a talk with different people and they were telling me they're too lazy, they're uninformed. It takes too much time, it costs too much money, the garbage is not picked up separately, they are students so they are living with others so it's not possible, or they don't believe in climate change or sustainability. Everyone has their reasons. What is your reason? Do you think it's good enough? I would like to explain my own sustainability journey. I'm not there yet, but I'm trying and I would like to share it with you. It started with when I lived with my parents. They separated the garbage with plastic, glass, paper, and normal garbage. They did not have a car or a driver's license, so I did everything by bike or with public transport. They also told me to turn the lights off when I was not in my room or when I was just not there. They also had reusable cups, reusable containers, and we bought things that were not in plastic. When I started to live on my own, I found it very difficult to be sustainable and how to do it. So I read an article and it said that I needed to divide everything in the house. The kitchen, the bathroom, the living area, clothing and food. I started with the bathroom and I wanted to use a shampoo bar, a soap bar, a menstrual cup and cotton pads to clean my face. When I started, it did not happen in one day. I just needed to finish my other products first before I could change, because I would not throw them away. When I was changing the products one by one, my boyfriend was going to use them as well, obviously, because there was nothing else. And he said it was just as easy. It was just something that he was not used to. I got so excited when I bought my new products. I started to tell my friends and my family, and they were excited too because I was enthusiastic, and they started to use it as well. I think you never become sustainable. I just think you slowly become more sustainable. Some other solutions are going to the market, asking yourself, is this really necessary? Go paperless, recycle and reuse, donate stuff that you don't use, eat less meat, try to invest if it's possible. For example, buy glass jars. It really helps to use less plastic. Just try. Try to do your best. Try if it works out for you, and if it doesn't, try something else or try it again the next day, as long as you just keep trying. Some bigger solutions could be starting at a young age with children, because if they grow up with it, then they are just going to live with it and grow old with it and learn their children the same things. You could give a class at school so they learn in a safe environment, or you could ask the parents to ask the children to get information about sustainability and inform the parents and things that could change in the house. There could also be workshops in the townhouse or online. The municipality could change that they are picking up different types of garbage, like glass, plastic, paper, and not just garbage. Grocery stores could only buy non-prepackaged food instead of prepackaged food, so the consumer doesn't have a choice. The consumer could only buy in the store non-prepackaged food, so the grocery store has to change, but that needs to happen in a big group. Or there could be multiple times a week a market instead of one time a week. I think those things will really change how sustainable a city is and how sustainable you are.
This is my first time going to the market in Breda. Next step is going to the market more and really ask myself, do I really need this, or is there a more sustainable option?
What is your next step?